Back together again. I'm not just talking about Louis DeBrusk and myself, but I am discussing Leon Draisaitl and Connor McDavid after having been split up in part of this series against San Jose on the ice and on the same line. Well, that's kind of a bonus because Leon Draisaitl might not have even been playing in Game 5. How does he respond after what happened with the spear, and how might that help Connor McDavid?
Yeah, he kind of dug into his inner Louis DeBrusk there with number 29 with the spear. And you know what? Uncharacteristic of Leon Draisaitl, but I think what that shows you is a little bit of frustration coming out in the top players of Edmonton, as we saw the frustration coming out in the top players of San Jose. They were able to get off those schneids and put up a lot of points in Game 4, and the Edmonton Oilers are looking for that type of a bounce back from their offensive players as well. Now, for Leon Draisaitl, good for him to only get a fine and not a suspension, and yes, it looks like they're going to be put on the same line once again, and why wouldn't you? That's the highest scoring duo in the National Hockey League this year, the Art Ross winner. They have a chemistry. They want to play together. It's an excellent option for Todd McClellan to be able to split them up, but also to reunite them and put them back together. I'm sure they're going to be a handful tonight in this game for San Jose, and they're going to be looking to have a much better game. You saw an uncharacteristic little bit of nastiness from Connor McDavid early in the game versus San Jose in Game 4, and then the spear by Leon Draisaitl. I expect a much more disciplined and a game where they're looking to put up some offense.
You discussed the fact that the Sharks' high-end talent responded in Game 4, and we're looking for McDavid, Draisaitl, and the Edmonton Oilers' top talent to do the same in Game 5. How big of a push will the Oilers have in regards to staying out of the penalty box after the Sharks scored 4 times with the man advantage to lead them to that 7-0 win?
Well, you know what? You know, you can't continue to give offensive players opportunity to play with the puck, and that's exactly what happened throughout this series too many times, is they've given them power plays over and over and over again, and as a result, you know, they're going to eventually find a way to score goals, and that's exactly what Joe Thornton talked about. He's only played 2 games. He picked up an assist in Game 4, but he said, listen, we're a very confident bunch, and we're a very proud bunch. If you continue to give us opportunities and you want to play a rough and tumble game against us, we have to make you pay on the power play. It's the only weapon we have in that regard, and they certainly did in Game 4. Now, that was everything going their way, but there's no question that for the Oilers, they have to be a much more disciplined team. And as you mentioned, Gene, it's not the roughings, it's not the hits, the body checks, it's the stick infractions. It's the infractions after the whistle. They have to buckle that up and just get a little more disciplined and understand it's going to be tough treading out there, and that's playoff hockey.
And the Oilers, their series with the Sharks down to a best of 3 with home ice advantage going into Game 5 tonight. For Louis DeBrusk, I'm Gene Principe for Sportsnet in Edmonton.